Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill. I hope you are enjoying the tier 8 week. If you are enjoying it, I am very, very, very happy for you. Thank you so much for your support. I know there is quite some beautiful comments in the section down below, right? I know, at least I hope you are having a good time. It is a Sunday for me. I'm still pre-making YouTube videos. I believe you can see that from the t-shirt. We had some very, very, very good battles, to be fair with you. We played very, very well. Apart defender, I did not make it work, but don't worry. I am going to play with the defender after like month or so, and I will try to make it work. And today I thought, why not to play with light tanks, right? And I was going through the light tanks, what I want to show you in action. And I thought, why not to play with a budget 12T, right? It is quite nice vehicle in my opinion. And plus on top of that, if I'm not mistaken, there is a discount for this vehicle now. If I am not mistaken, right? So why not to do that? Plus on top of that, from this vehicle, you are grinding towards two tanks over there. So two lines of the tanks. So you need to play some battles. And I truly enjoyed playing with this vehicle long time ago. I marked it. It took 59 battles, probably less than that. And we managed to get like 2 grand of damage and 1,300 assisting damage, which is very, very great score for a light tank, right? So I will try to show you how to play with this vehicle. But one more thing, pay attention at my crew. My crew is very, very, very sad, unfortunately, with this vehicle, so this can affect our performance. Anyways, let's try to get as much use as we can, and let's hope for a better maps. Prokhorovka, Kempinovka, Redshire, and something nice. And before we are going to get Himmelsdorf, I can't look at this, fellas. I cannot look at this. I cannot look at this. Please tell me when we are going to have a battle, okay? Not like I was cheating. Don't pretend, fellas, you saw I was looking like this. Don't pretend, mother truckers. I mean, you can't even see it, can you? I thought so. Okay. What do we have right here? We have a tier 9 battle. We have the Seren Coast, which is definitely not the best map for us, but we will try to get as much use as we possibly can. So, the first things first, fellas. What do we want to do? I believe we want to go somewhere in the middle to get as much assisting damage as possible, or as much early information as possible. Aha. And I know very, very fine bush for that. So, how do you want to play with this vehicle? Fellas, even in the city maps, this tank is not that horrible. Why am I saying so? Because this tank is having a potential, right? With this vehicle, you can pretty much clip someone out, right? For 600 damage or something. And that's definitely a great help, right? For your team. So, when you cannot spot, you can always do damage, right? Remember this kind of stuff. So now, right here, for a very first couple of minutes of the battle, we are going to silently sit in this position, and we are going to wait until we will figure out more things. For obvious reasons, we do not want to go into the heavy line. It's simply not worth it. Enemy light tank is being super aggressive over there, and that's not a very smart thing, because budget as a tank, it's quite massive. It's not, it is not a small light tank, right? So far, so good. I'm not complaining about the situation, and we want to go just tiny touch more aggressive over there. As you can see, they have plenty of forces here, but once again, I am feeling completely fine with this. What do I want to do? I want to be a sneaky, breaky mother trucker idea. What exactly do I want to do? I want to go like this, and I want to check out, maybe do they have Arta somewhere over there. Apparently, they have Waffelcock, which is not Arta, and you know, I don't really want to F with this guy over there. Plus, on top of that, we know how many of people do they have around this area. And this is many, many, many people over there. So, how we could get the maximum use of all this? I'm trying to figure out the things right here. How about if I will try to find the angle to shoot the guys which is playing around this area over there? That will work. As you can see, the first miss over there, not much what I can do. The second miss over there, the third miss over there. Can we get 1 out of 4? Beautiful. 1 out of 4 is better than 0 out of 4. So now we are just waiting until we are going to reload, and we will keep trying to shoot those guys over there. And once again, we are just trying to get as much as we can from this position while not being super aggressive in the battlefield, right? I think it is completely fine. So wait for it. Now look, I would love to see this Vazatank destroyer sitting around this area right here, right? In the open field, but apparently we can't see shit. Wait, maybe this Leo is going to move back. If so, we are going to hit him. That's movement back. That's good. And one for the team. He might push even more back. But apparently, he's not getting spotted right here, which is kind of a problem. Wait for it. Aha, was a tank destroyer and Leo. Let's try to bang this Leo over there, right? Actually, this time we hit 2 out of 4, which is a bit better than before, right? How about if we will try to check out, do they have a Wafflecock which is sitting around this area, right? Prepare for it. And now we are pretty much, we want to go just tiny touch more aggressive like this, just a bit, okay? And what we want to do, we want to clip this mother trucker out of here. Let's see where he is. And we manage to spot Arta. So we don't care about the Wafflecock right here. And we can just destroy Arta. Arta is destroyed and now we are running for our life. That's good. Probably this Wafflecock is still in the same position over there, which is completely fine, fellas. I am not complaining. I'm just running away, right? Good. We came back into the same position right here, and now we should have another magazine, right? Since we have another magazine from this position over there, we simply can bang the guys which is playing in this area. That's great, fellas. All we need to do right here, we need to have our eyes open. This is very, very important thing, fellas. Open your eyes and bang everyone. To the left, to the right, to the left, to the right. And as you can see, Wafflecock is making a pressure for us, which is completely fine. I'm trying to cross like this. We manage to do so. And now we are playing the game which is called Cat and Mouse. You spin me around and round and round. I'm waiting until our guys is going to deal with this situation over there, and then we can do something for this Wafflecock over there. Plus, on top of that, remember, the Lynx might join the fight against this guy. That would be very, very welcome, right? Can we hit him? Sure we can. 169, and he just missed his shot. So currently I am feeling just tiny touch more aggressive, and I'm feeling so much better, right? Lynx is joining the banging fiesta right here. He missed another shot and we are just simply clipping him out. What do we want to do? We want to kind of escape right here so he is not going to hit us once again. And the Lynx is having a beautiful time while trying to claim this beautiful chicken life, right? That's very, very good thing. So Can we hit him once again? Sure we can. And one for the team. Poor Wafflecock. He have very, very poor action right there, fellas. So he is taking one for the team. Good. Okay, what do we want to do now? Now we want to go for the motion. I know one thing. We can flank the motion and we can pretty much clip him fully. And get pretty much 600 damage or something. If I will learn how to drive. Meanwhile, this guy just tried to use auto aim. But luckily we managed to find the cover in front of us. And hip hip hooray, now we are booming. Okay, wait for it. We have a convoy which is next to us. There is no rush for us. All we need to do, we need to wait until the Maushin is going to make one or another mistake. Maushin just made a mistake, he shot. So what we are going to do, we are going to use the auto aim right here and we are going to bank his side. And one into the side. And two into the side. And three into the side. And now one into the butt. Beautiful. And now I'm just simply flanking this guy and annoying the shit out of him. He's thinking, you little mother trucker, and I'm saying me. That's me, and what do you want to do? And this is the main problem, fellas, when you are playing with a big fat meatballs like Maushin, right? You might be in quite some trouble over there when the light tank is catching you and simply banging you without even asking your name. So that could be a problem. Now I'm trying to escape and I believe I should be fine against the Maushan right here, although a Mx hit me in the face. That's quite a disappointing thing. Anyways, enemies is capping the base, which is not very good, fellas, and I must admit I am currently sitting in the big shithole. I don't want to give... Woo! I was about to say I don't want to give this Maushan opportunity to kill me, but apparently he did that. Now, pay attention what is happening over there. Our Maushan and Tortoise, slowly but surely, they are going to go into the cap. Whenever those two guys is going to enter into the cap, we are going to win this battle. I believe this should be a victory. Maybe I picked my opponent quite badly right here. I know one-on-one I would kill this Maushan without bigger problems whatsoever. But apparently that was not one-on-one situation and he had a friend, a Mx, which decided to help him. Maybe I needed to ignore Maushan at one point and simply go for a Mx, clip him and then keep banging this Maushan or go for Tortoise and I could make this battle so much better. But once again, now we can only talk about this. But would be if I would be a good player in the World of Tanks, right? Mistakes were made already, victory is victory even in this, and I'm super happy about that. Luckily we are winning this and we managed to get 3,500 damage, which is, once again, speaking about the tier 8 light tank, it's not bad. And in this game I don't really think we could spot as much, right? So once again, not a big deal and not a big problem, my lovely friends. Victory. Good. I like to win battles and I believe you like to win the battles too. So remember this position where we played in the middle, fellas, next to those two houses, you can actually bang the Bravo one in, and Charlie one position if enemies are getting spotted, and usually they are spotted there for all the time. So this is very powerful position with a light tank or with a sneaky tank destroyer if you could get over there, right? So as you can see, we are top by the damage and top by experience right here. I'm super happy with this, and this guy played very well. He countered me for banging the Maushan, and that was quite sad thing, but you know, I cannot change it. Anyways, second game with a bot chat. Let's go, fellas. I want to get something where we can spot, because once again, light tanks is about the spotting, and if I'm not mistaken, fellas, this is one of the older light tanks in the game, right? So I would love to show you some massive spotting damage. By the way, speaking about the massive spotting damage, I have couple of videos prepared for you. Well, not couple of videos, but couple of good replays prepared for you with a Lynx tier 8 Ferrari. How to spot with a shitty ass view range, you know? So I hope you are going to enjoy it. It's going to be beautiful. I'm speaking about the score, and hopefully you will see some one or another interesting position in the Kempinovka, right? Anyways, what do we want to do here? Budget. First things first, I like to spot the people which is crossing like this, okay? It's very important thing, and I really want to spot those guys crossing. So how we are going to do this? We are just simply going to the Echo 4 position. It's the best position to spot enemy crossing. It is the best position to spot them crossing, fellas. And we are in position. Let's see. Wait for it. We arrived into this position very quickly. Now, if someone is going to try to cross, we should be able to spot them without bigger problems whatsoever. I'm speaking about the slower tanks, right? Pantera is relatively quick. Why we did not spot anyone? That's actually very debatable and questionable. Very interesting. I don't really want to see this Borat getting spotted, because I might take one for the team just because of him, right? That wouldn't be fun. I could take a bigger risk right here, boys and girls. By saying I could take a bigger risk, I could try to go into this bush over there. But once again, it's very risky. And I'm not willing to take this huge of a risk. So far I'm not feeling very happy with this performance over there. The main reason why am I not feeling so happy, because apparently Apparently, I did not manage to outspot anyone going into position. Well, what can you do? What do I want to do now? I want to spot the bushwhacker over there, because more likely they have a light tank right there. No, they don't, because I'm not getting spotted right there, which is even better. So I have flexibility myself to move. So what we are going to do now, we are going to go for this super hellcat over there and 80-15A, right? So look at this, Schnei, though both of those guys is in the open field right there, and our bushwhackers is simply banging them without even asking their name. That's great. Okay, how about this mother trucker? Can we eliminate him from the game? And one for the team and two for the team. Beautiful. This guy is eliminated, and now we have the mother trucker, which is going for us super aggressively, which is completely fine. We have some support over there. We are yelling for help because, once again, remember, what do we have? We have a couple of the bushwhackers right here, and this guy is going super aggressively. We are hitting him once and we are hitting him twice. That's a track, so he's not moving. Our guys is trying to support us. We are trying to flank the light tank, which is not so easy thing to do. We are flanking, and unfortunately he have an angle on us, which is not so good, but oh well, what can we do? Not much. So he survived so damn long, to be fair with you, and that was very, very unfortunate. Apparently we did not have too many people which could support us right there, although as you can see, those guys probably could shoot him when he was over there, but it's okay. So far, 1000 assisting damage, well, tracking damage / assisting damage, it doesn't matter. To be fair, I am feeling completely fine with that either way. And now right there, what we want to do, we want to bang this Pantera, which is sitting over there. It's very, very important kill for us. He should burn to death, and apparently he didn't burn it to death. And to be fair, this ELC even helped him. Oh well, what can you do? Better luck next time. Next time, fellas, we should be able to eliminate this Pantera from the game. At least that's what we need. And to delete this ELC even. Obviously, if he's going to make one or another mistake right here, right? He's very, very tiny tank. It's very hard to deal with him. Okay, fellas, I have another idea. What do we want to do? We want to escape from over there, because otherwise this ELC even might eliminate us from the game, and that would be not fun for us. So what we are doing, I'm actually thinking about this bush over there. Maybe that will work. And Super Hellcat is in the open field and he managed to snap us. Okay, I deserve this. So, what happened in this game, fellas? We was doing damage and we was spotting. As a light tank, I think we played very, very well and we was trying to give as much distraction as we actually could. But unfortunately, the most unfortunate thing was a majority of our guys decided to go over there. I'm speaking about the heavy tanks, and they got destroyed over there, right? Looking into the guns, we lost two guys over there. Okay, three guys over there, and we lost like shit ton of the people around this area, right? As you can see, this is like cemetery for our guys, which once again is kind of unfortunate, but not much what we can do about this. That's why usually I am not going with a heavy tank over there, right? So in the end of the day, probably enemy team played better, but don't spit into the water, because we might need to drink it, because we still have a Borat, and Borat have a potential to simply one shot this guy, and he can probably shoot the Tiger for 370. And now Borat is on the reload. With the next clip, Borat can eliminate this guy from the game and this guy from the game, and the score is going to be equal. Borat is very, very powerful tank nowadays, so maybe my life wasn't that important compared to the Borat life, right? Anyways, fellas, we will come back after a second whenever we are going to finish this battle. Give me a moment and we will come back with a score. It's your bet. Is it victory or is it defeat? Looks like I was panicking a bit too early. Our Borat managed to carry this battle and hip hip hooray. Well, to be fair, it's very, very hard to push from the heavy side through the open field, so not a big surprise, right? Good job to our Borat. I definitely did not play this battle ideally, fellas, but I did as much as I could, and I am not complaining too bad with my personal score over there, right? 1,800 damage, 1,100 assisting damage, not bad battle whatsoever. And as you can see, Borat, this mother trucker, managed to carry this game, which is completely fine. I am not complaining with that whatsoever. Okay, fellas, time for a last battle with my most loved non-premium light tank tier 8. I love it, I like it, I am having a blast with this vehicle, and we are going to play on the Wiener map, where you can see two beautiful statues over there, if you know what I mean. Okay. What can we do? What can we do? What can we do? I believe we can spot them heavy tanks crossing. How we can spot them crossing from very, very safe position over there? I will spot heavies. I will spot heavies. Cling, cling, cling. Please shoot. Clinched, clinched. That's how I imagine light tank speaking in the battlefield. I will spot heavies. Don't blame me, okay? I am watching too much cartoons. What can I say? Okay, if enemies are going to make a bad crossing over there, we should be able to spot them without bigger problems whatsoever. And as you can see, right here, there is quite some guys which is thinking about crossing through the open field. So we are going to try to snipe them ourselves because we have the magazine, right? And we can do everything without bigger problems whatsoever. So, can we get some assisting damage? Sure, we cannot. Yeah, it's okay. Two out of four shots for in our favor, that's completely fine, right? Now, they might have the slower mother truckers which is trying to cross like this. So, just wait for it. Wait, we have all time in the world of tanks. By the way, our tank destroyers is playing super aggressively over there. Okay, how about that if I would try to spot the mother truckers which is playing over there, okay? I am just trying to get a tiny touch better angle, but apparently we cannot spot Kaku. Oh well, what can we do? What I could do right here, I think Lynx lost shit ton of the hit points right here, right? If I'm not mistaken. So what we can do, we can select auto aim and we can bank him without asking his name. That's great. Okay, Sue managed to miss his shot. That's very, very good. And now I'm running for my life. You see, even though when you are getting the city map with this vehicle, it's not that bad. And now the main reason why this vehicle is not so bad in the city map. You have a clip. And this is a massive advantage over other light tanks. For example, MTV or whatever else, another light tank shitter, right? What will happen? He's going to hit someone for 150 and he's going to cry in the corner. Meanwhile, you can clip someone for bloody a lot of damage, right? And that's very, very important thing in my opinion. Look at this Dede. Now I have the memories from that game mode which we recently played, okay? Where the Dede Fede is very, very powerful tank. When the Dede Fede is boom, 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 when smacking you for 500 and you are crying in the corner. But not in the randoms, my lovely friend, not in the randoms. So, we are waiting until we are going to reload right here. Whenever we are going to reload, we are going to prepare for another clip and we will repeat the same thing until the enemies are going to cry in the corner, right? Once again, wait for the Dede Fede. Eventually, he is going to arrive over there. That's what we want to see. And MX is trying to run. First shot into the MX. Second shot into the MX. Not very good clip by me, but once again, I have no rights to complain about that. That wasn't a good play by me. Bad aim. What can I say? Okay, how about this Dede Fede? What do you think? Can we make the Dede Fede regret his life decisions over there? And one for Dede Fede. And two for Dede Fede. And three for Dede Fede. And four for Dede Fede. Okay. So far, idea, as you can see, we lost so many enemy, we lost so many forces, it's crazy. Apparently, we can't do anything for the enemy team. That's quite sad thing. That just pretty much means enemy team is playing way, way, way better than our team is, right? But look at the bright side, at least we still can get some use in this battle. For example, Dede Fede in the open field, 1 for Dede Fede, 2 for Dede Fede, 3 for Dede Fede, 4 for Dede Fede, Schnei. Dede Dead Fede is dead. We are going on this on the golden clip right here, and Batchet might try to make a pressure on us very, very soon. But once again, I don't care because I'm about to have a clip. So I am feeling completely fine. And yes, I completely understand I am separated from our forces over there. But once again, I still have a hope maybe they are going to kind of ignore me and do something else, right? But as you can see, Batchet is making a hardcore pressure. He should be dead very, very soon. He's down to one shotable. So now I am feeling so much better. And he is thinking, aha, try to go on me. I have the supporter. And he's absolutely right about that. He has a supporter right there. But once again, I have no fear. I am just going to bang this bloody links for his life. And yes, ram me. At least I'm getting some more assisting damage. At least I'm getting some more ramming damage right there. So let's think about this battle. In this game, we did not manage to spot anyone. And one of the main reasons why that was the case, there was way too many Ferraris. No one likes Ferraris. Three links, which was going through the middle of the field while saying, that wasn't the best thing to get into this bush over there or to spot from over there. Plus, on top of that, our team managed to lose the heavy time, the heavy line, which happens. It's definitely not the best light tank map in the world of tanks, right, my friends? But in the same time, I am feeling quite good with this performance just because I know we tried to get as much use as we possibly could right here, and we got as much use as we could, right? We did not manage to spot that much, but we got solid 2,600 damage, right? And it's very, very clear thing, fellas, in the world of tanks nowadays. You cannot have 100% win ratio. It's just simply impossible in the current world of tanks, right? And when you and when the battle is going 15-2, 15-6, doesn't matter. You do not have too much influence, right? It is, world of tanks is a team play game. And if you are doing everything properly from your side, if you are feeling like, I was fighting like a truck of dildos, I was fighting very, very well, and I did everything properly, right? So there is no point to be nervous about that or simply say it's simply not worth it, don't you think so? So that's great. The third battle with a Batchet, 2,600 damage, which is not bad whatsoever. Like I said, I'm very, very happy with the score. And I am not going to act surprised if I'm going to be top on the damage in this battle. You don't believe in me? Watch this. Watch this, fellas. So, 2,800 damage, and we are top on the damage right here with the light tank, which is understandable, right? Like I said, we did everything properly, and I'm very, very happy. And this is the advantage of the Batchet 12T over other light tanks overall, right? So, in the end of the day, how we played this battle? We played for a 2.7, overall we played for a 2,700 damage and only 300 assisting damage, but in the current situations which we had, right, we simply could not spot, my lovely friends. We did not get those massive spotting maps, Kempinovka, Prokhorovka, Redshire, even Ghost Town, right? We was getting semi-city maps or the maps where we did not manage to spot, which is completely fine. So this is the score, 2,700 damage, 300 assisting damage. Am I happy with this performance? Absolutely yes. I still have the same thoughts about this vehicle. I love it with all my heart, and I think this is beautiful tier 8 light tank. So if you can't spot, do damage. Thank you so much for watching, fellas. That was your daily dose of skill. I hope you enjoyed this one, and see you tomorrow. Peace.